All right, yo, 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 what up? I'm back. Sorry for the wait, guys. Had to get some food. Some of that Chipotle life. Jafiel. All right, also, in case you missed the first half of the project, we created a beat from scratch. Went from a sample from Ryan Leslie with a little piano jam, and we chopped it up in Slice X, and then came up with some chops, added a pad, and then we eventually just last thing we did is added this additional instrumentation here. We created a bunch of stuff for it, so we did a lot. But now time to mix it down. We're going to finish arranging it right now, and then we're going to mix it, and then we're going to add all the, you know, bells and whistles that we can. So, just to give a listen to the whole project one more time, here we go. This, so there's a reason I arranged it like I did. In case you didn't know, song structure is a thing, an important thing, and for this one, oh shit, word? Alright. Cool. Now playing music update. All right. Cool. But yeah, sorry. I was saying arrangement, song structure. It's a real thing. People like it. People expect it. If you don't do it, you're kind of oddball out. So. Basic song structure is intro, then hook or right into the verse if you put your hook slash chorus in right after the intro. Then what you're doing is you're getting 4 bars for the hook, sorry, 8 bars for the hook, and then the verses are 16s. Now you'll run into some verses that are longer, some verses that are shorter, hooks that are longer, hooks that are shorter. But for generalizations, most beats are 4 to 8 bar intro, 8 bar hook, 16 bar verse. We got a bridge, that's going to be another 8 bars maybe, right before the hook drops again. And again, it can change, it just depends. So with what we have right now though, as we were listening, I just realized how repetitive this sounds. It's good to take a quick break every so often when making beats. Just because it can get boring. Or not boring, but you want to refresh your mind, you know what I'm saying? So what you do is, for this one, we're going to take the hats off. So we're going to make it unique. So you click a little piano thing, go to make unique, right? Then we can just get rid of all these for now. We'll put them back in. Double click it to open it up. And then we're going to get rid of these hats. Maybe we're going to slow them down. Actually, let's slow them down. Get rid of that. Let's get rid of those. We're just going to basically erase every other one of these. Leave those two is fine. Boom, boom, a boom, a boom. Oh. Boom, a boom, a boom, a boom. And then we can leave that part right there for now. Let's see how it sounds. Just the pattern. Cool, not bad. Actually, you know what? We could probably even take something else out. Let's see what else we can take out. Because that's really all variations is. You take stuff out, you add stuff in. You take stuff out, you add stuff in. So for this one, we're going to take stuff out. Because I don't want to add too much. I want to make it busy. Because then the rapper doesn't have any room to do anything. You know what I'm saying? So let's see what we got. I think we can probably see what happens if we mute these, see if it still has energy. Because if it does, we're set. If it doesn't, well, then we might have to put some in. Here we go. Let's see how it sounds. So now that we have that, it's right here, we can add the faster hats because we're picking up the pace again. So we'll just go back to pattern 3, which is when we made unique. Remember that? Kill those, add those in there, right? Then we're going to do the same thing over here. Oh, wait, you know what? This is when the beat was supposed to drop. That's all right. Take those out and put these in. So now we have 2 and 2, right? So let's check it out. Slower down. What we can do actually for that, instead of keeping this thing repeating, push it up. We'll make it all pianos. So let's do this 21 in here. Actually do is add the bass pad we had. So how do we do that without having to go in there, copy, paste, erase, and all that fun stuff? Easy. So you click on the pattern, right click, flip by channel, boop, and it named it for us. We have Nexus and Dark Pad. Bring the Nexus down here. I like to keep my stuff in a relatively organized manner. And I say relatively. You'll see stuff that doesn't where it should be, but whatevs. So now we have, here's the bass, or the pad, and we can add that only, right? Probably just take that off too, let's see. I like that. So now though, you realize the drums never switch up once they start, other than the hi-hats. Boring. Let's fix that. Click on pattern 5. And we'll throw that at the end of each one of these four bars. Throw that there, and we'll throw this here. And really what we're doing now is giving it some variety. Also, I did a no-no. See how I turned these off? They never showed up again. Let's turn them back on real quick, right? Now they're all on. Alright, we don't need those things running the whole time. Let's find out. Is it reusing 4 anywhere else? Nope. So, click, highlight, click and drag. Yeah. So if you click too many times, just click one time. Yeah. Click and drag. Control X. You just cut it. We're not going to paste it anywhere. We just took it off. Now when we play it. Left it so 3 and 5 still play it, because that's when the piano's coming. We want that energy from the piano is still going. So cool. If anything, we can even throw in these Rico drums and see how those sound. See what Rico does for us. Alright, I kind of like that, but what we're going to do here is we're gonna do the same thing we did at the outro of the intro, right? Get it? Yeah. So we're gonna, this actually went farther, didn't it? Let's bring that back down over one. Cool. So, we don't need these, but I want the hats. So, double click. Copy them hats. Copy. I also want those. So we'll do, I think control should do it. Nope. Alt maybe? Nope. Oh, shift. Weird. All right. Click the first one, boop, and then shift, click, 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 dang it, click, 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 and click, control copy, as in control C, and then we'll start a new pattern, find first empty, and then paste it there, if my FL isn't frozen. Is it frozen? No, we're good. Paste. Now we play it, it's just the hats. If that ever happens, you just double click it, maximizes and all that fun stuff. Now we have that, we can throw those in like this, yeah? And get rid of these two. Because now we got the Rico drums with hats. And then the hook comes back in. Boom, diggity. Jaw feel? Jaw feel. I feel that. So we've got some variation. We've got the track mostly arranged now. Yeah, because then all we're going to do after this is copy, paste, keep dragging her over, right? And then highlight the verse only and the new hook, control B. Now we have two verses, we have hook, verse, hook, and then we can do a bridge if we wanted to. We'll do a bridge, we'll play something cool. Where did my, there it is, we'll do that by itself for the bridge, right? Thank you. Right. Now we throw the pianos in there. And if anything, we'll cut that in half, throw this on there, we'll cut this in half too. But from the back, right? So we have the ending of it with the extra switch up. And we'll move that to over there. Alright, because we only want 8 bars. We don't want another full 16 of that. Good, but we don't want that right now. So then we paste this over here. Keep dragging this bad boy over. And thwap, right there. And don't forget our little snare drop in. Boop and boop. And... oh, sorry, snare dropping goes over here. And I like to copy and paste the hook twice for the outro, because I'll just let it fade out. I don't want it to just be over, right? So, we've got the track arranged, we've got variation, we've got a bridge, got an intro, got some hype. Now it's time to actually do the mixing. This is the fun part. Now again, we're going to check that we have everything in there, and I know we don't, but we'll see. Y'all remember how it's done. So, busiest part of the beat is the hook. So we'll start it from the hook. Hats don't have it. This doesn't have it. Oh, just the hats now. Come on, hats. What are you doing, guy? Stop being a rebel. Play by the rules. Alright. Time to, you know what, actually, you know, we'll do the bells and whistles. No, we want the bells and whistles in before we mix it. All right, time to add in any effects, risers, drops, and things of that nature, all right? So we've got proper kits. We've got sound effects. I don't want any of these, but these are just random effects I have. Here we go, SFX. And they're all super organized. This is a kit I found somewhere online. Don't recall where. Rearrangement? No. We want a upsweep, give it that rising feeling. We want a medium one, nothing too long. Long is more really long. We don't want that. So let's see what we've got. Let's kind of run through these. Nope. Nope. Kind of like that one. I like that one. That, my friends, is what you call white noise. Alright? Literally. Time one bar, right? Time stretching it so it fits to the one bar we have here. Yeah? I want to have control over when it happens. If anything, I can now take it back a little bit and go to two bars. Right? Paint, right-click the pitch and reset it. And the reason that does is it now doesn't change the pitch. It keeps it default pitch even though you time stretch the shit out of it. Doesn't sound good. Sounds mechanical now. So resample it, and that undoes the pitch thing you just did. So let's see. Cool, welcome to the beach. That's what it sounds like. Now we're gonna send that to its own channel, and we're gonna have to drop the volume. We're gonna automate the volume on this thing. So, easy way to do it. Highlight your area where it's gonna be affected. So pencil tool. Automate volume. Bring this down to 0. That's at 100. I like to just keep the sweep what it was going to be anyways. If anything, don't even put it at 0. Put it at like, I don't know, 30%-ish. You can tell at the top left up here, or if you have the helper thing down here. Yeah, it's really loud. Drop the volume all the way and we'll figure it out here. Cool. Now we're going to put an equalizer on that bad boy. Equalizer to the rescue. Equalizer. Alright. No bass. I don't want anything taking from my 808. We're gonna go in and clear everything out. That sounds cool like that. I'm gonna throw a reverb on there, because I like reverb on everything, except my drums and usually just the drums. Drop it down a little bit and start it there. Cool. You hear that? If I just hit it? Sorry, let's see here, where is it? Automation, unsorted, nope, it's in audio. Do all, there we go. Hold it, listen for the reverb. Part of here, but good. It's subtle, but it'll do its job. If anything, turn it all the way up and hear it. Very subtle, but it works. So, got that. And now, the best thing about that is, you can just reuse this everywhere, right? So, control copy that. And where else do we want to put it? Let's see. Right before the beat drops, that's always a good place to put it. So we'll put paste, and it just puts it first bar available, but we can just click and drag at that point. This is right before it drops, so we'll hear it again. Now, and then we're just going to do that again over here somewhere, so the copy, paste that, move this over here, right before the next hook drops again, paste that again, right after, right here. So basically everywhere this little snare, tap, 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 tap comes on, we're going to play this. Jaw feel? Jaw feel. I feel it. Can you feel it? Sublime is so sublime. Cool beans. Got our sweeps. Now we need our vocal tags are going to go in there next. If you don't have any, pick a sound effect. It's really easy if you go look it. This is mine. If you can guess where I got that from, 10 points. Did you guess? I'll explain after. Let's see if anyone figured it out. It's really awesome. I love it. And that kind of gave away the name of it, but whatever. So, right here. That's a dry version. I have a wet version and a dry version. I'm going to use the dry one. I, when I do my vocal tags, like to do it immediately before it's the drop. Probably on this third right here. So when I play it, it's going to sound like this. But that's when it already drops, so we need it over here. Because this is before any drums come in. Cool. Double click. Control L. For there. We're going to get an equalizer on there. Like always. Equalizer goes on everything. Give me my bass back. Turn up the eyes to give it that radio soundish. Then we're going to go to some delay. Now, you have to be careful about the order you put your stuff into. Fun fact, if you do delay then reverb, your reverb is going to affect every delay. If you do delay after reverb, then you're going to be echoing the reverb. So experiment and see what you like. It just depends on what your vision is. If you want it to do that, then do it. But it'll be up to you to play with it. Now, I have been doing my own mixing on this, and I've explained these ones so far a little. I've used them both. I used both these in the sample, actually. So I'm just going to kind of speed through it here. I'm going to leave it on default, right? Turn the reverb down. Delay is definitely going down. Hardcore. Because I don't want it to be too loud. Right-click stereo effect, because I want it to bounce from left to right. We're going to set this to 2 steps, and we'll see how it sounds. A little too reverby for me. So let's see what happens if I move it up, if it makes a big difference or not. Still kind of going, so let's do this. There we go. Turn down the delay a little bit too. Cool. So now when I play it... Perfect. And then... if you don't want to go through the trouble of finding your own sound, I don't look like Robert Downey Jr., but that's cool. I'll take that. And then we've got, if you don't have any sound effects, the next best thing to do, have a friend of yours say stuff for you, like this one. My friend Marcella here, back in my dorm days, he was walking by, and I was making a beat or something, and I needed something that said, who made the beat? And I was like, hey, can you say this for me? And then I had her just record a bunch of stuff, so.
You're rocking with the fifth element.
Did that.
This is another. You got the fifth element. This is another. The fifth element. Eddie, it's the fifth element on the beat. Ayo, fifth. You just made that. Damn.
Cool. Pretty cheesy, but it's pretty cool when you do it. I feel really cool, at least. We're just going to do this basic one. I like this one. This is my one I always use all the time.
On the beat.
And the best part is, it fits almost perfectly right behind my laugh. Or the laugh I use. It's not my laugh. I wish it was. That'd be cool. So, I'm going to have to, again, same process. Control L. Take it down to an equalizer. Oh, wrong one. You know what? Fuck it. We'll use this one. They all do the same thing.
It's the fifth element on the beat.
No bass.
It's the fifth element on the beat.
I want a little bit of mid.
It's the fifth element on the beat.
And I want that high on there. Now, we're going to mess with the levels and whatnot once we get to the mixing process. But right now, we're just making it sound with all the effects and prettiness that we want. That's awesome. I am the Robert Downey Jr. of beat making. Say what? JK. I don't know. Continuing on. Delay. Turn that shit down. Then we get the reverb. And then we're going to turn that one way down too.
It's the fifth element on the beat.
Huge difference. Let's try that without any effects.
It's the fifth element on the beat.
With all the effects.
It's the fifth element on the beat.
Nice. So, I'm satisfied with that. Now let's hear how it sounds playing it.
It's the fifth element on the beat.
Cool. So that works. Now, next thing to do. Fun fact, little sisters work, siblings, moms, dads, anybody really. If you got a friend who has a microphone, have them say stuff for you. It's really cool. It's really easy to do. We've got some upsweeps, we've got our intro. I think that's all the bells and whistles I want to add for now. There's always stuff you can add in between, after the chorus, between your verses. I mean, there's all kinds of stuff you can add in there, but don't overdo it, you know? So yeah. So we've got that going. Now it's time for the fun part. And by fun part, I mean the most annoying to anyone listening to you making beats. Because you're going to sit there and you'll be tweaking every sound to make it the best sound it can be. Too big. So, I like to arrange my stuff and make it look good. So this is way too small. Let's widen them up a little bit. So that way we can all see nice and clearly. I like to work with a small canvas just because I'm weird like that. I like having everything compact. But for the purposes of this, that way we can see a little better what everything is. Let's start with arranging these in a way that makes sense. I like to do it basically in the order they come in, but group them together. So I'll have the pads first. So where's the pad? So this is going to be a part of it because that's the Nexus. Put that at the very beginning. Whoops, too many. There we go. Then I need the pad right there. And then I want the sample, which is right here. Cool. Those three are my sample. This is my empty channel. We're going to color this. And you right click, rename, and then you just click on this, and you've got all these color choices. We're going to make it pink, because why not? I want to find a nice and bright, there we go, pink. I'm going to name this dash. Cool. That's this section now. Then we got our drums and kicks, snares, blase blase. Kick all the way to the left, 808. All the way next to the kick. Then I want my claps and my snares next. This kick right here, we didn't even use it. Never shows up. Waste of space. Let's do this. File, browse states, default. Guess what? All clear. As soon as it does it. And you keep your mic on. It keeps cutting out when you're not talking, and the background noise sounds weird and it's inconsistent. Yeah, most def. Give me a second. I'll clear off some of this noise, too. 1 minute.
It's the fifth element on the beat.
That off.
It's the fifth element on the beat.
Oh, wow, that was cool. Accidental, but awesome. And then let's go into the settings here real quick. Uh-oh, where is she? There she is. Settings. Microphone gate. Let's just leave it on, huh? If it's any better, let me know. If it's worse, just say so. Alrighty then. Cool beans. If you guys want to hear the full product real quick, a quick preview before we keep going. This is the full thing. I'm not going to play the whole thing because it repeats, but I'll just show you the chunks.
It's the fifth element on the beat.
Word, my bad. I don't know how to fix it otherwise. I'll work on that for the next one. But anyway, so this is a verse. That's the basics there, and then there's a bridge down here where it just cuts off, it plays just this after the... Oh. back to the mixing now. So we've got Nexus, the pad, the samples. Musically, that's all we have. Everything else is 808s and kicks, snares. This track, we started it from scratch like an hour and a half ago, or maybe. Something like that. Yeah, I'm going to post the, if it's not already up, a video on demand of the first half, and then the second half of the mix. It's all been on the fly, so I don't know how long the first one was compared to this one, but I'm calling this the second half, because mixing is its own beast. You're producing, a lot of times you're going to mix your own stuff if you're just showing off beats, but if a rapper gets on it, and you don't care to be the engineer, somebody else is going to do all this part for you. I like to know how to do it because I'm broke and I'd rather not pay anybody. I do have a SoundCloud. Let's see. SoundCloud.com/THA5THElementOfficial. Alright. So then, we've got our kicks. Right, our kick, our 808. Clap. We need a snare next. So I like to keep those paired up. Clap the snare. And then, what was this? That's a hat. We'll do the hat next, because that's the next most common. We have our four percussions. Here's the other, here's the rim shot, which comes in like twice. So we'll leave that after the percussions. We've got the little vocal sample that comes in. Then we've got our sweep, and then the vocals. That should be everything. Only 20 tracks. Not too shabby. Next up, we have got two. So this is a separate now between the claps and all that stuff. I don't care to separate after the instruments personally. So I'm just going to get rid of that. And the way you do that again is Alt and to the left. Cool. So the kick, we have equalizer already. We have it compressed. And that's it. Don't want to do anything else. It's just a punchy kick. Oop, wrong one. Punchy kick. Where is it? Right here. No! This is exactly... Oh, there it goes. Got scared. Well, you should save. Let's save it right now, just in case. And thanks for the follow, Doc. Appreciate it. Awesome. Kick. Let's arrange these as well. And this one, Alt and just up. And it does it all for you. 808. Tap up until it goes up. Then we got the clap percussion. This was the kick we're not going to use, so we can just delete that. Next up, we've got the rim shot. Below the percussion is fine. The snare, we wanted it up higher. And then the hat, we wanted that up higher because that's more common. Cool. Chant, we never use silent at all, so we can delete that. Bye-bye, silent. Alright. Hopefully we didn't need that, because if we did, I just deleted it. So, alright. Now we can truly mix. The way I like to do it, everything gets turned off. Everything goes off. Everything must go. All of them down. Slide, 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 slide. Now, if you have a MIDI keyboard and you want to get fancy, you can totally link these little things to your knobs on your MIDI keyboard. For example, if I do this one, link to controller. And then move it, and it automatically links it. Look at that. Hands-free. Well, mostly hands-free. Either way, you can do that. I personally don't care to do that. Only because I don't trust my... how smooth I can do it by hand versus how I can do it looking visually. I'm a very visual person. So yeah. Visual, that's what I do. What is this? Oh, enable slot effects, cool. So, Nexus has nothing. So let's clean that up, first of all. Which, and Nexus is this sound right here. So we're going to go to Pattern, Mixer, and we're going to reset it real quick so we can hear it. Equalizer. Yes. Hey, what's up? Yes. Question mark. All right, and then so this part, what we're doing, the same thing, giving the 808 all the room we can. There's a little bit down here, not a lot, very basic, but we don't want that, none of it. Give it space. Same thing with the top end, down. All right, now be advised. This middle part right here, this little red one, is where your vocals are gonna go if you put a wrapper on it. That's a strong part of the human voice. So we're gonna drop that a tiny bit. Now, is it gonna affect our sound? Oh yeah, but hopefully not in a negative way. Let's find out which is the most essential sound by cueing all the way up. And then, so it's really sharp, and we're gonna just drop it, and we're gonna play with it and see what happens. We're gonna do that there. We're gonna widen that a tiny bit, yeah? And then we're gonna bring it up. We don't want it too low, but we do want to bring it down a little bit. Cool. We've got that. Got it. Next thing we want to do, it doesn't need reverb because it already has reverb. Nexus has a built-in one. See? Reverb has a delay. Built in. So don't need it. Don't want to add too much. Don't want to take away from it. So we're just going to drop that volume again. Now, what I like to do is find the most what's up, Killuminati EDM, yo, and Days Music. What up, yo? But yeah, so what I like to do is decide what is the most important part of my song. And by my song, I don't mean what part do I like the best, although sometimes it coincides with what I think is the best part of the song. For me, the best part of the song is what's going to catch a rapper, what's going to catch their attention if I'm trying to sell the beat. If it's a standalone track, what's the most interesting part of the track that's going to catch the listener's attention? You have to try to go at it from a consumer's perspective. I mean, you know what I'm saying? DJ Nick, yes, 100%, way better to use DAW reverb than Nexus reverb, 100%. But for this example track tutorial, it'll fit the purposes we need. I've used the reverb from Nexus before, and it's a trend in the industry right now to where most people are used to whatever reverb they hear from the VSTs, even though they're not great reverbs or not great delays. They're just, I don't know, it's, I read it somewhere, and then I started hearing it. But that's just something a little more advanced. That's a little out the scope of what we're going for this time. And then also, myself, when I'm lazy, I don't even worry about it. It's not a big deal, personally. Unless, if it's giving you the sound you want, do it. That's my motto, at least. So anyways, back to the best part of the song. I honestly feel like the best part of the song is that 808 when it knocks. The sample and the 808 are the two biggest parts that I think are most important. So we're going to start with the 808 because that's going to take up so much room. Plus, that's the part we've been clearing out from every single other area for. We've been kaling the bass on everything we can so the 808 is not competing. I'm doing great, Killuminati. It's another day in paradise. My first stream this awesome. Well, not awesome. I don't know. You guys tell me. But yeah, I used to get stage fright and then make really whack shit. So far, I'm okay with this beat. So, we turn the volume up on the 808. We're going to take it, we're going to reset it first. That's going to put it at 100. We're going to drop it down to 80, if not 75. Reason being, it doesn't have to be as loud as possible. It has to be... it's what matters more is how loud it feels. You know what I'm saying? So if everything's at 80... when we do the final mastering, and I'll show you that, and it's another really cheap thing to do that a lot of real engineers will frown upon hardcore. But I personally don't mind. I think I've gotten great results with it. I've sold beats before. I haven't gotten any complaints. And again, like I said, if it gives you the sound you want, do it. Who's going to tell you otherwise, you know? That's the nice thing about music. It's all an opinion, you know? Now, some stuff is wrong. Don't let your 808s clip. Don't turn the volume up on everything. Don't even mess with the knobs on this side unless you're automating and all this other stuff. And if you're doing that, then that's really, like, you don't really need to hear what I have to say about it because you probably already have your way of working with it. But any volume changes, for the most part, should all be done in the mixer. That's why it's someone's job to just work on this. Unless you specifically are tweaking the volume, this is all you need to worry about. So we've got the 808s in. We're going to highlight the area where everything's in it, which is right here. There's the 808. Boom. Mm-hmm. She's already saturated. She's got her equalizer on. We've got it just a little bit, not a lot. Letting her take all the room she wants down below. She can have it all. She gets it all. She's my 808. She's a star of the show. That and the sample. The sample's going to be her boyfriend. Ryan Leslie, the good sir, made a beautiful piano piece, in case you missed it. This is from the end of his song called Black Mozart. And it is awesome. Did I buy Nexus? Nah, dog. I am broke and asshole and didn't buy it. But I am, like every other asshole on the internet that steals it, gonna buy it, chance I get. So, yeah. So, Nexus. Sorry, you confused me. No. Sample comes up next. That's in Slice X, like I showed earlier. This was on Black Mozart by Ryan Leslie on the self-titled track. And there's this little piano piece at the end. We're gonna turn that up. In relation to the 808, it's so good. Oh, I just, Pirate Bay, dog. Everything from the PirateBay.org, not the other BS ones. Good show. So. Piano sounds pretty. You see how low I have it compared to the 808, though? It's at 60%, okay? Compared to the 808's 80%. It's perceived volume. So, boom. Next star of the show is latest Nexus. Oh yeah, I don't even use the latest one. I got two or whenever the last one came out. Next is the pad, which is subtle. I mean, look how it's literally four tones. It doesn't even have any progression to it. It's literally doo. And then when I did it, I have the velocity on low. Now that can be used as a volume modifier, but also a lot of instruments, like I said before, have the attack changes, a lot of the stuff changes. So you want to set your velocity if it affects your sound. Otherwise, don't use it as a volume control unless you know what you're doing, unless you get the sound you want. Again, that's just the rule. If it sounds good, do it, but yeah. Anyways, continuing on. So, next goes this bass. Now, it is going to be clashing a tiny bit. This is 808 space. This is also 808 space. We don't want to take away from this bass, but we want it to do its job. Let's turn it up. All right. See how much louder it is on the sliders? But how perception. So, continuing on. Nexus is next. This is the new one. This is the one that we added in there. Everything has an equalizer. Everything has an equalizer. Does this have? Yeah, I have a filter on this one instead of an equalizer. But otherwise, same thing. I'm cutting frequencies, giving it its own space. Matter of fact, I should probably give it an equalizer, but we'll worry about that some other time. Let's get this cracking. All right, I'm satisfied with that so far. But now when you bring this kick in, I totally forgot about the kick. The kick is best friends with the 808. They go together. It's important that they go together. So we're going to go together with them. Turn it up a tiny bit. That's giving it the punch it needs. If I turn it off, it's just boom with nothing much. Put the kick on. Now they're gonna hear other laptop speakers, phone speakers. That's the entire point of mixing. You wanna make sure it sounds good on everything you can. And this little punchy kick, they won't hear the boom, but they'll hear the pfft. That's all that matters sometimes. Because they'll get the idea. Next, the clap. I have done nothing to this clap. So let's solo it, reset it, and let's hear what we can do with it. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Basic clap. Gets an equalizer. Everything gets an equalizer. Uh-oh, look at all that. You don't need that space. Shot, 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 shots. Just kidding. Turn that up a tiny bit, not a lot. And then it drops. Now we're gonna add a compressor. Not that it needs it, but I want it. You can feel free to not use compressors. And like I said earlier, I don't know how to use a lot of these, and you shouldn't follow my lead in not learning each tool. But I've decided I rather just focus on making more stuff. I've been doing it for like 12 years, so. You see that clipping? We don't want it to clip. Bring it down. But that's going to be the start of the show for the second half of the track. So let's unsolo now. Be quiet. Oh. I want to give it a little bit of reverb. And by a little bit, I mean subtle. Is how we're gonna check it. All the way off. And then slowly turn it up. There it is. That's too much already, you can hear it. So somebody told me this once, and for some reason it has been, I use it and I don't use it, on and off, but you turn your reverb up just enough so you hear it, and then you turn it back down, like a tiny bit, like you use it just underneath where you know you can hear it for sure, and it'll keep it subtle. Clap so far is good. We're gonna come back over here just to this half because this has everything else in it, and then we're gonna grab the snare. It doesn't have an equalizer. Whoa, time to EQ. Oh no, I definitely am a big worried about not clipping or getting volume, but I've found other worker, you know, mixing it down. I usually give each thing its own space without getting too loud. But no, I definitely agree with you though. Learning about compressing is essential. Everyone should learn it. If you're gonna make beats, learn to use your tools. Don't worry about getting the nearest, newest, latest plugins or whatever the new hottest thing is. Learn what you have and you will make so much better stuff than the average Joe, I'm telling you. Yeah, that's one thing I regret not teaching myself, but between production, rapping for a while, engineering a little bit, and I say that very lightly. Graphics, all that fun stuff. I'd rather not learn that. Would I say I'm a professional? No, I haven't really gotten paid. I have an album on iTunes that's made me $20 total, and I've had it up there for a while, so no. I'm not getting paid for it really well. I was for a while getting paid, but it was more for my studio time. And my tracking and what little I was mixing back then. So I was a professional, and now I'm trying to be a professional again. I think being a professional indicates you have to get paid for it. But I don't know. I've been doing it for a long time. I love it. It's fun. Oop, wrong one. The snare. Took away the room for the 808. I want this, though. That. You guys understand why I'm doing that part? Let's see. Gives it that. If I turn this all the way up, it gives it that deeper end without being too deep. You know what I'm saying? Oop. Over here. All right. And then this one up a little bit. Yeah, exactly. Helps cut through the mix. Not only that, but I want to remain the sound quality, like the features. You know, like if I cut too much off, right? Sounds flat. See, super flat. Doesn't have the same characteristics. If I take it back now too much, all this little stuff at the bottom, at the back, right over here, is taken away from the 808. You can't even hear it very well. So I stop it right where I find that characteristic I like, and I like this part. And then this can come up a little bit. This can come down. I have a lot of highs already. Cool. So now when I play it all together with everything else, should be able to hear the snare underneath the clap. Subtle, but important. Once we have that on there, you can always throw a compressor on there if you'd like. I'm not going to. But, Trap God, I wish. That'd be awesome. And I've been told I look like Robert Downey Jr., so that's pretty awesome. I like him, he's cool. He's a superhero. Issue, do you guys see this clipping over here, though? No bueno. This clap is definitely clipping. Clap down a little bit. Alright, still clipping on the kick though, so we'll turn that down a little bit, and we'll bring the 808 down too a tad bit. What's funny is I'm going to ruin all this hard work we're doing with the next plugin I'm going to use. I don't need those keys in my pocket. But we're not there yet. It'll be a surprise. A really bad surprise that everyone will see coming. Hi-hat time! Hey, guess what the hi-hats don't have? EQ. Everything gets an equalizer. I don't care if it sounds perfect already. You want to make sure it sounds perfect. And you don't have to use the one I use. You can use any equalizer. See, look at this. Why does a hi-hat have bass? Unnecessary. Can't even tell I cut that off. Very subtle. I'm cool with that right there. Doesn't need to be loud, just needs to be there. Next, percussions. Alright, you guys know the drill. EQ, EQ, EQ. This one's not a bad. This one gets an EQ. I'm just gonna bang an EQ on all of these real quick. I'm gonna bring this up a little. I'm gonna bring all four of these so I can hear them all, because they're a team. They work together. If anything, what I should be doing is routing them. You know what? I'm gonna do that. So this is an empty channel. 20 is empty. I'm gonna bring it over using Alt and Left till it's right in front of all the percussions. Now, I like doing it that way. You don't have to leave it there. You can put it wherever you like. But, see these little lines? That means they're all going here, into the master track. I don't want them to go to the master track. I want them to go here. We're going to rename that. You can hit F2. F2. Get the rename window open. And we're going to name this Open Hats. the open hats now are all, I want them all to get pushed through this channel, then this will be the, what dictates the ultimate volume here. So, what I can also do, instead of putting an equalizer on every single one of these, none, I can cut them all off at the same time. It's called routing or something cool like that. I don't know the actual phrase. There's a lot of things I don't know. That's one of them. But it will make things a lot easier in the final process. So to do that, we want to disconnect it. So click on it, tell it, disconnect, and it's just a regular left click, disconnect, and disconnect. Then you're going to connect it here. The way you do that is this is going to go boop, boop, boop. Nope, I did it wrong. Never mind. Ignore that. I did it wrong. Hold on, let's see here. This goes to here. There we go. That's what I want. That goes there. That goes there. That goes there. And that goes there. So now these should all play through here. Nope, not this one. Forgot one. I don't want that going through there. I want that to go there. Awesome. Now we're going to EQ UO, just because, and cut off all the bass, all at once. They're a little loud, so I want to turn them down. I'm just going to keep turning them down until they sound right. You know what? I'm gonna add reverb to every single one of those. Why? I just like reverb. Reverb's fun. Oh, same as before. I'm gonna leave it at default. Turn this all the way down. Turn it up. If it's your desk or my desk, if it's my desk, it's probably me just being retarded, but the 808s probably are shaking the desk a little bit. I do have my sub right there. Cool, got the reverb, we've got the hats all done. Wait, no, reverb, EQ. I don't want to compress it. I want to leave it as is. Don't need any more. I don't need to lose any more dynamics. That's the bad thing about compressing everything. Everything just gets smashed super loud, and then nothing stands out. You don't have any dynamic range. The quiets aren't as quiet as they could be, and so on and so forth. So, this percussion, in case you guys haven't heard it yet, is actually from a part we haven't even touched, which we should go there now. This intro. Now we also need this piece, because this is an important part of that. It doesn't have an equalizer. We'll use EQ2 this time for no reason other than we can. And like we did before, right click, type. We want it high pass, because we want to let the high pass through, if I remember it. And then steep 8, because we want it to cut off immediately. And I want to give it some mid. So when I turn it up a little bit, you'll hear it. Very subtle, it's not a lot. Oh no, I saw a mistake. I don't know if you guys saw it. There is a mistake in there. So, the wave file tells me I overlayered one of these. Time to find out which one. I'm pretty sure it's one of these. Nope, not that one. Is it this one? Yup, you see that? Boom. And I saw that because of the waveform, one of them was a little bigger than the rest, and they should all be the exact same volume. There we go. This one I'm gonna compress. I want it to be nasty and loud. And again, complete mix. Works for me unless it doesn't, but for the most part it works. Now this piece is from the Jay-Z Rihanna track, Run This Town. Love this little vocal clip. We gon' run this. Huh? Everyone knows that part. Cut that off. Give it that. Drop it down. Awesome. And now, I want to give it a little reverb, not a lot, again. Drop it down low, girl, drop it low. Turn it up a tiny bit. Too much. Too much. There we go. Very slow. I don't want to give it any more. That's good. I was going to give it some delay, but I decided against it. Now let's hear how it sounds. Cool. Now, it's time for the rising, this part. Now for my favorite part. Turn this up tiny bit. Take out some of the mids. On the beat.
It's the fifth element on the beat.
There we go.
It's the fifth element on the beat. It's the fifth element.
Oh, we haven't even gotten to the fun part of panning. This is my favoritest part of everything I ever do. This is what I feel like defines a producer or beat maker who took the time to really paint a beautiful picture. It's all about painting a picture. So check this out. This right here is what I like to call wave candy. Somebody let me know there's other visualization tools that are free and really good. But this one has always done the job for me because built in, first one I found out about, and since I found out about it, I can't let it go. So wave candy into your main master track, because basically we've got everything volumed out properly. But we don't have perfect. It's not a surround sound. I want it to feel like I'm in the beat, you know? I want it, and that way when the rapper drops in and he's sitting in the middle of that track, everything is like surrounding him. He's like in the middle of that circle. He's rapping and the beat's just like, oh yeah, you got it. The only thing that's there with him is the kick and the snare maybe or something, because that clap's gonna get spread out a little bit too. You'll see what I mean by that. So function, and we're gonna, theme, and we're gonna go down to vector box, because that's my favorite one. It looks the prettiest. And by the prettiest, I mean it's the most visually effective for me. Alright, we're going to listen to this track from the very get-go. And you're going to see, if it goes straight up and down, it's perfectly centered. If it's wide, that means it's going left and right. Alright, it's a pretty simple concept. If it's down below more than it's above, that means it's giving you the perception of being behind you. If it's more above than it is below, then it's giving you the perception that it's in front of you. Now, that's not always the case. And sometimes I talk out of my ass. So, your results may vary. Also, if any of this touches the very top or the sides, I'm probably clipping. See how it's spinning? See how it squiggles sideways? For me, that's too thin. I want it to be nice and wide. I want a fatty. I want it to be everywhere. But this is how we do it. It is called, I'm going to bring this down over here. Hopefully you guys can still see it without being too crazy small. And if you can't, we'll bring it back up in a minute. Put it over here. All right. So, Nexus, which is our... this part. Let's give it more room. Let's have it take up more room. Stereo shaper, not enhancer, shaper. We're gonna shape that, baby. Should be popping up here. There she is. Control save. Right click. Stereoize. Subtle effect makes a big difference. Next one. Dark pad. Same thing, except this one is going to get Stereoizer 2. And the pianos are going to get Stereoizer 3. Stereo shaper. Give a subtle one.
It's the fifth element on the beat.
Now, when we look at it, vector box. It's moving a lot more sideways. And that is stereo separation. It's such a subtle thing, but it makes a world of difference. See how it like gets wide and then it comes back in? Music to my ears. Literally. So. Wave candy off for now. Need to save that precious CPU. Because of what we're doing now. This is what I like to call death in a plugin. Reason being, it's extremely easy to overdo it and do it wrong. I don't always do it right, especially because I use presets. But, he needs it, because we want to make her sound full and life and exciting and give her that final mastering touch. Called the mastering plugin, Isotope Ozone 5. These are all the different ones, different presets, a million and one a day, which is awesome, but we have genre-specific stuff. Don't even mess with those. I go to general purpose, or I find one that I like. I usually like upwards expansion, or upward compression. Sometimes I just go and I play with the different ones, and I find what I like. Excitation and widening was my favorite, but I think I messed it up. It might be too loud. Find out. Alright, do you see the difference in the volume alone? Because this is a compressor. It's stereoizing the whole thing, and it's given a harmonic exciter. You've probably heard of that if you've ever been on Making Hip Hop, the subreddit, or if you've ever been on a lot of production forums in general, they'll tell you, oh, put an exciter on it. It's great for your 808s. Well, here it is. This is an exciter built into this bad boy, and it is exciting, but easy to overdo. If I put it at 100%, it's going to sound weird when the bass hits. You'll see.
It's the fifth element on the beat.
Ugly. See the difference? Nothing. Everything. how giant and red my base is now. Now it's time to subtract. I gave it the initial volume, the initial like mix I wanted after this plugin. Now time to really go in there and tweak it for the final touch before I put it up on SoundCloud. It's dark as hell in here. Let me turn on the light right quick. Don't know if that helped. But anyways, so now we come in and we touch it, and we touch it, and we drop it down. My 808, down boy, pick down a little bit too. Preemptively, of course. And now we can hear it in its glory.
It's the fifth element on the beat.
So let's put it on the spectrum. This is the visualization of what your sounds look like on an audio spectrum. Closer to the bottom, bass. Closer to the top, highs.
It's the fifth element on the beat.
See how empty it is? Plenty of room for vocals. Mozart was what we named this one. Let's save it real quick before we die, because we didn't save it. Save it. And then, for shits and gigs now, a random thing I'm going to add in there. For those of you who want to use remixes and vocals and stuff like that, this is a Eazy-E acapella that I grabbed from a different track. Put it at 70 beats per minute. It's a whole nother process for a whole nother tutorial, but...
Everything's good in my hood and it's on and poppin' easy. Motherfucking E from East Side, South Compton. gangsta, 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 gangsta. Is that what they're still yelling, nigga?
What? I hope it's on tempo still. That would suck if it's not.
Gangsta, gangsta.
Nope, it's not on tempo. Terrible news. This one should be on tempo. Let's find out if this one is. Oh, wait. I think it's supposed to be right here.
Good in my hood and it's zoning, popping easy. Motherfucking E from Eastside, South Compton.
And then that gets its own track, and we'll turn that way down because it's way too loud.
Good in my hood and it's zoning, popping easy. Motherfucking E from Eastside, South Compton. Straight giving up the real on how a nigga feel. Talk that shit, motherfuckers, caps get peeled. Laying low in the cut, getting high in the motherfucker. Niggas know what's up. I'm that gangsta, gangsta. Is that what they're still yelling, nigga? G to a T. Sagging and bailing. Live by the gun. You know what I'm saying, Ren?
Yeah.
So I guess I'll die about that motherfucker then. So when I die, niggas bury me. Make sure my shit reads easy, motherfucking E. And it's a fact, to be exact. My tombstone should read, he put Compton on that map. And that's how a nigga feel when I'm giving up the motherfucking real.
Boom diggity. All right. Thanks for tuning in, guys. I will be sure to put these up for video on demand on my YouTube, on the Twitch, on whatever I can. And if you have any questions, feel free to ask. I am on Reddit. I'm one of the moderators on Making Hip Hop. I'm also on Instagram. I'm also on Twitter. I'm basically on everything. If you just look up THA5TH element, you'll find me. Alright then.
Peace.
No, it's awkward because I have to stop recording. Oh god. I don't know how to stop recording. Boom. Alright, now for real.
Peace.